standing here in Northeast Portland in a really urban neighborhood that is typical of urban areas in the Willamette Valley, and surrounded by a whole variety of ornamental and native plants, different types of plants, even some edibles incorporated in the design around this particular rain garden. I'm standing here in this particular rain garden with a beautiful example of several classic rain garden plants that are built down in the base, or the moist part of the rain garden, one of which is this Douglas Spirea. So Douglas Spirea produces really beautiful pink, purple, and almost a white-colored flower in different varieties, and it's very tolerant of flooding conditions. And we also have Juncus effusus down here, which is another very flood-tolerant plant, and slough sedge, which is a very, very common sedge found in wetlands all over the Pacific Northwest, easy to come by, and very, very low maintenance. And then all around this rain garden, you'll see some really unusual plants that you wouldn't normally associate with them. These are the kinds of plants you would find in vegetable gardens or in your typical home perennial garden. We've got daylilies over here. We've got gladiolus that are coming up. There's some volunteer sunflowers, all kinds of great plants. There's even some asparagus growing behind me here. So this particular rain garden designer decided that they wanted their yard to be multi-purpose. Some of it's edible, some of it's just for ornamental purposes. But the beauty of this is that the rain garden is a nice focal point. Okay, so here's another really cool plant. This is Cicerinchium, or yellow-eyed grass. It's growing right here. Really beautiful little plant. These are kind of tolerant of both the wet and the dry that you get in a rain garden. In this case, he's got these plants planted on the berm, or the top of the rain garden. He's also got sword ferns over here. He's got all kinds of really cool plants. There's even some Irish moss growing in here. There's bleeding heart growing in this area. There's lots of bleeding heart over here, if you take a look right there. There's all kinds of stuff. This sedum is a beautiful example of a common ornamental plant you could find in a rain garden. And this is one of my all-time favorite plants. This is New Zealand bronze sedge. It makes a beautiful plant, nice accent, and it grows really well in some cases in the base or the wet part of the rain garden, and in many cases in the drier part of the rain garden. So here's asparagus, of all things, growing at the top of a rain garden. And here's another spirea. Daylilies. This is western bleeding heart, a native plant. You can also find horticultural varieties of it. Daylilies, which grow really well in a variety of conditions, but obviously in this case they don't want to put them in the base because they won't really tolerate being flooded all the time. Good old sunflower. Gladiolus. A very small Japanese maple, beautiful maple. And here's another classic rain garden plant that many people put in, which is dogwood. There's several different varieties of dogwood that will do well in a rain garden. They can be fairly tolerant of the moist and also fairly tolerant of the dry. Here's mock orange, beautiful flowering plant that has very, very fragrant flowers that bloom in the springtime and will just fill your garden with really nice fragrance. Here's a hellebore growing down here that bloom in the wintertime, but in this case we've got a nice foliage in the summer. Okay, so I'm standing here next to the outflow of the rain garden, and it really is just an outlet that flows directly across the sidewalk. There's no trench drain, there's no connection to a storm sewer, but what is happening in this rain garden is that it's graded very carefully to flow back that way towards the other end of the rain garden. So when it fills, according to this owner, the rain garden fills all the way to the back and then flows in this direction towards an overflow. On a rainy day in a typical urban center like Portland, the rainwater has no place to go when it hits these hard or impervious surfaces. So as it's striking on them, it flows off in great big sheets or sheet flow, where it runs off until it hits the roadway and is conveyed to a storm drain.